I want to be the best in class.
Luxury retailer Holt Renfrew will be closing January the 11th. The department store has been open in our city since 1950. Its current location is the corner of 102nd Avenue and 101st Street. The company says it wants to focus on its bigger stores. Last year, it announced it was closing its menswear store in Toronto.
It's not on our downtown.
Now you can add most Disney stores. Three Disney locations in BC have already closed their doors for good, with another 10 shuttering by August, including the West Edmonton Mall and the Rideau Centre in Ottawa. The three staying open are all in the Toronto area, Eaton Centre, Scarborough, and the Outlet in Vaughan Mills.
Tell me something I don't know. Tell me something I don't know.
Disney is a marquee brand, and their current retail stores weren't really state-of-the-art, weren't really best-in-class.
And just found they had a first-class series of arrangements in place.
I want to be the best in class, whatever I do.
Who do we need to attract to this mall? Who else is in this space? And I always think, let's get creative about this. Could Netflix consider a bricks and mortar retail experience?
Hudson's Bay has made the decision to close its Bloor Street store on May 31st, 2022.
It's not really a surprise.
Retail analyst Bruce Winder notes that the department store sector has shrank over the last few decades and says this was a natural progression.
And I honestly feel, you know, when the dust settles, they'll probably have, you know, one store per major city in Canada, maybe two in a couple of instances, but certainly not that close together.
In 2020, amid rolling closures and restrictions, HBC stopped paying rent to landlords at several shopping mall locations across the country. Last summer, an Ontario Superior Court judge ordered the retailer to pay the rent owed for its Hillcrest Mall location in Richmond Hill.
They've been notifying the public. You notice that like Fairview, for example, and I think this is good corporate citizenship. It would be easier for them, you know, to just sort of not mention to anybody the fact that they had a case at the Fairview Mall, went to inspect that mall, and just found they had a first-class series of arrangements in place in terms of directional signs, and they have these people called ambassadors who help you to sort of follow the rules. And transparency is important. The reason we're talking about cases in malls and in stores in malls is because they are made public.
I think it's a mistake on the Bay's part, but they're, like everybody else, probably constrained and constricted during COVID and having to make some really tough decisions. I'm disappointed, but it's not on our downtown. Our downtown continues to grow and will thrive, COVID or not.
A retail expert told Global News downtown Edmonton has seen increasing challenges for retail over the past 30 years, but Mayor Don Iveson says it isn't necessarily indicative of any such problems.
Retailers are going to make their own decisions, and so that's really up to them. You know, retail is changing all around the world. Lots of businesses are making different decisions, so I wouldn't read too much into it.
Another major retailer is leaving downtown, with Sport Chek permanently closing its Edmonton City Centre Mall location in March.
We're deeply committed to, a revitalization of downtown, tackling the safety issues downtown. We're always concerned whenever we lose a business in our city.
most coveted address in Canada, not even in Toronto. It is the best real estate corner in Toronto. I would also say that it's the best place to live because you can walk out your front door and literally walk to the best restaurants in the city. You can walk to the theater, movie theaters. You can walk to the best shopping district in Toronto. You can walk to the grocery stores. You know, you've got Whole Foods, you've got Eataly opening up.
Eataly, McEwen. McEwen's right across the street.
And Eataly's across the street. Pusateri's. You have all the best high-end shopping there is. You have the museums, you've got the best university, you know, within walking distance.
Could Netflix consider a bricks and mortar retail experience?
You have the best hospitals in the world, you know, within 10, 15 minute walk or 5 minute drive. So you've really created an environment that is a real pied-à-terre where you can walk out your front door and have the best of the best. Basically, including the best shopping, you know, with Holt Renfrew across the street and Manulife and everything else and all the other shops.
So inside you have the best of the best and outside you have the best of the best. So inside you have the best of the best and outside you have the best of the best.
Best in class, whatever I do.
You got it. Really?